Zack Kassian recently moved into the double digits in goal scoring. He's the fifth Oilers forward with 10 or more goals on the season, along with Connor McDavid, Leon Draisaitl, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and Alex Chiasson. Zack Kassian, you know, he can be inconsistent. We don't know if he's playing up with Connor McDavid on the first line, maybe on the second line with Leon Draisaitl or Nugent-Hopkins, or if he's going to play a fourth line role. But clearly he's able to play higher in the lineup rather than just playing an energy role.
Well, I think if in a perfect world, Kassian would be your third line right winger with enough offensive ability to get between 10 and 15 goals and the ability to skate and also protect people as he can. He's, however, shown the ability to play with much better players in, you know, Connor McDavid and with the Sedins in Vancouver. Small sample size, perhaps, but lots of guys play with Connor McDavid and get nothing done, and he has played with Connor and he is getting something done. And the goal he scored in Buffalo was a goal scorer's goal. You know, a hard pass from Connor that skipped once and he hammered it into the net, as Leon Draisaitl's been doing for the last 6 weeks. That was a goal scorer's goal. That was a player who was picked in the first round of the draft would score. Former teammate of Taylor Hall's in Windsor in junior. So it's a plus for the Oilers to get a player who's played farther down in the lineup, be able to move up and play with McDavid or Draisaitl or whomever. But like I said, I think in the perfect world, he's a third line player. He's perhaps overpriced at 1.95 if he's just going to play 7, 8, 9 minutes a game on the fourth line. But at 1.95 million on the first line, he's perfectly priced and he's doing very well, showing the team that he's got more offensive chops than we gave him credit for sure.
In some ways, he's actually filling the role that Milan Lucic was tagged to when he first signed here. You know, Milan Lucic has underperformed these last two seasons, considering how much the Oilers are paying him.
Ken Hitchcock has wanted a protector on that line for quite some time. He mentions it all the time with Connor McDavid, and whether it's Draisaitl or Ryan Nugent-Hopkins on the other wing. He's wanted somebody with some toughness, and he had Milan there for a while, and it didn't work out, you know, for the long stretches, and now Kassian's there. You're right, he's taken the role that Milan would have, but I have to take a step back. I think Milan Lucic is skating better now the last couple of weeks than I've seen him for a long while. Whatever line he's on the puck, he's making things happen for the people he's playing with, and I think he's very nicely placed in the lineup as well on a second or third line role. So not much to, apart from that Toronto game where they got blown out, not much negative stuff with the Oilers now. And some of the players that were, you know, letting Connor do it for a long time are now stepping up and helping out some support players, of which Kassian is probably the number one benefactor.